Utile me sobar, you will arrive. Roma pilia, it la wella sabo. It is a roll papala, papala. It is a roll papala, papala. It's a mocket que la boat. It's
a mocket que la boat.
It's a mocket que la boat.
It's a mocket que la boat.
It's a live rule. It's a live rule. It's a live rule. It's a live rule.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our hosts for this evening. Hall of Fame inducted marketing executive, author, entrepreneur, and general badass, Bozema St. John. And TED speaker, three-time New York Times best-selling author, podcast host, and the professional troublemaker, Lovie Ajayi Jones.
Hello. All right. Well, we know that we are mostly African in this room, correct? We all are African, come on. We're all descended from Africa. So let's hear a bigger noise. That's right, that's right. All right. Well, welcome to all of you to the Africa America Institute's 38th annual awards gala.
Yep, yep.
And thank you to the NAACP for hosting the fantastic cocktail reception. Yes. Y'all were getting lit during the cocktail reception, is that correct? Yes, you were, clearly. Well, we are so excited to be here tonight. And by the way, we should also, let's just keep practicing clapping, okay? Because we're gonna clap it up if you're grateful to be alive, present, and in this room together. Okay, good job. We're gonna keep clapping all night long, so don't get tired, okay? Now, look, we know that the pandemic took so many people from us, but despite that, all has gone on. We're here, we're still standing, and if you ask me, that's truly something to celebrate. So let's keep celebrating tonight. And since its first annual awards gala in 1984, the AAI has invited a global audience to celebrate Africa and her worldwide diaspora during the United Nations General Assembly. We have done so because much of the discussion during UNGA is necessarily about problems, but we also need to take time to acknowledge and celebrate progress so that we can be inspired to continue the work. So let's clap it up for some inspiration also.
Yes. And this year's award ceremony will center around the theme of Africa in the world and will honor an illustrious group of leaders across industries who have used their platforms to advance and affect substantive change locally, nationally, and globally in their respective areas. Tonight also marks the culmination of the organization's 38th anniversary of the awards gala. I don't know about you all, but I'm excited. So let's give it up for the African American Institute. Come on. See, No. The energy is too low. No.
Too low.
I feel like we're not celebrating enough. All the magnificent melanin in this building.
Yes.
We're not celebrating hard enough. So let's do that again. Okay?
Yes.
Yes, yes, we're going to get it together. I feel like what happened is we didn't start the night off with Afro beats.
It's true.
Really feel like the defect is we didn't get the vibe. So we're going to try to figure out if our sound person can give us some Afro beats at some point tonight.
At some point.
So tonight we would like to thank our sponsors, including Chevron, the NAACP, Access, Afrexim Bank, the United States African Development Foundation, Bloomberg Foundation, and Head and Heart Philanthropy, and all of tonight's sponsors and partners. Bose, I have a question for you.
Uh-oh. What's your question?
I'm going off script.
Exactly. This is dangerous.
Okay. So what does it mean to you to be African in the world?
It means I'm bomb, yo. That's all. That's all. And you, my dear?
Ooh. To be African in the world means to be grounded and to always have home no matter where we go. That's what it means to
me. Okay. You see, this is why we work so well. I'm just going to give the short answer that makes no sense, and then you're going to go ahead and give the one that's thoughtful. Fantastic. Well, look, we need to continue with the evening.
Correct.
So, but before we start, we would like to bring up onto the stage the president of the Africa America Institute, Kofi Apenteng. Please welcome Kofi.
Thank you so much.
I think I can just use the mic.
All right.
Good evening. My name is Kofi Apenteng. On behalf of the Africa America Institute's Board of Trustees and staff, I want to welcome you to AAI's 38th Annual Awards Gala. The Awards Gala is an occasion to highlight and celebrate Africa and its worldwide diaspora. Just look around the room. It's a beautiful gathering. We're delighted to be together in person again at last. In the course of tonight's celebration, we'll connect people who might not otherwise cross paths and highlight connections between ideas that might otherwise be obscured. Connections between the arts, commerce, technology, and the basic necessities of life, all the while centering Africa. Part of the gala tradition is to celebrate one African country at a time. And this year, the Republic of Botswana is a standout. As you'll hear more about later, the reasons are many. High levels of educational attainment, especially among Botswana women. Welcoming migration policies that support refugees and skilled workers alike. And constantly improving health indicators, despite the setbacks due to more than one pandemic. We are honored that President Mokweti Eric Kiabetwi Masisi has joined us to celebrate the people of Botswana and their consistently progressive vision. Perhaps like me, many of you found escape during the COVID shutdowns by streaming movies and documentaries. The cultural influence of film and filmmakers is profound, not to mention their enormous economic impact. Around the world, people's attitudes and behavior both shape and are shaped by the images and representations they are exposed to or deprived of in cinema. Tonight we celebrate Mahen Bonetti. Founder and director of the African Film Festival, Inc., for her vision to build a bridge between African cinema and the world. We have seen how challenging it has been for many business leaders to include the well-being of society with the pursuit of growth. We are so proud that an African has set an example that inspires the best in us. So we celebrate Solomon Assefa. Solomon is a vice president of IBM Research, and we celebrate him for his commitment to promoting disruptive technologies that hold the promise of transforming industries, benefiting society, and advancing rather than sacrificing sustainability. And of course, for life itself, we all depend on food. Our bodies, mental faculties, emotional well-being, and overall health depend upon good nutrition and nourishment. And yet, as the Rockefeller Foundation observes, the way we eat today is failing both people and the planet. It isn't nutritious, it isn't sustainable, and it isn't equitable. With deep gratitude and a tremendous pride, we celebrate Betty Wambui Kibara. Betty is the director of the Rockefeller Foundation's Food Initiative for her work to prioritize public health, food safety, and build resilience to climate change. So to borrow a phrase from the late Lucille Clifton, the inimitable Black American poet from Buffalo, New York, won't you celebrate with me? In accordance with our tradition, before we begin tonight's celebrations, we take a moment to look back at some of those we have lost over the last year.
There's nothing as important as having a belonging. Knowing where you come from, knowing where the motherland is, and then knowing that you have the ownership of the whole continent.
At AAI, our mission is to promote enlightened engagement between Africa and America through education, training, and dialogue. AAI strives to enrich the social fabric of humanity by transforming the way we understand Africa and its worldwide diaspora. Since our founding in 1953, our alumni include over 23,000 Africans who have received scholarships and fellowships from AAI. We always stay connected with our alumni and share their journeys and the lessons they've learned with a broad audience. And these Africans are now an esteemed network of alumni, many of whom are leaders and influencers across public, private, and governmental sectors in Africa and globally.
To close the gaps of knowledge is critical. It is critical for peace, it's critical for development, it's critical for a wonderful world. And that's where AAI can continue to make a difference.
Over the last 2 years, we've had a lot of time to reflect on what's our real purpose. We've really looked to the lessons we can learn from our principal co-founders, Henrietta Van Noy, Horace Mann Bond, and William Leo Hansberry. Reconnecting with our purpose has opened up new avenues for us. The best example of that is our school services program, focusing on Detroit, working with local school districts on reimagining how students get introduced to Africa and its worldwide diaspora. Our focus has been to introduce all students to Africa prior to periods of European domination so that people really understand that Africa was present and important from the very beginning of humanity and continues to be important in shaping our modern world.
What AAI is doing, it makes quite a difference. Cultural diversity breeds a lot of richness in the people. That will ensure the continent makes it. We develop. There is success.
Young people are curious about the world, and they need to be introduced to the world in a way that is soundly based on scholarship and how much we all have in common, how we're all part of one human family. It's our hope that this work will not only engage students, leading them to have better outcomes, but will also help make us, as a society, feel more unity. This work is also important on the African continent, where students often are not introduced to Africa as part of the world from ancient times. So over the next few years, you can expect to see us working in Africa and in other parts of the United States, where there are leaders in schools who would welcome this kind of work. This has been enormously rewarding for us, and we look to continue this work into the future to help build a better world.
Okay,
So
here's the thing, y'all. Remember we said that it would be great if we had some Afrobeats? Y'all remember that? Just like 2 minutes ago? How'd you forget already? Okay. We're trying to work on that playlist now, but I had an idea as we were standing here listening to that very inspiring video, that perhaps we should let Lovey sing some Afrobeats.
This is a trial.
Because, you know, she's a three-time New York Times selling author. She's an entrepreneur. She's a speaker. She TEDx. I mean, she can sing some Afrobeats, right? Y'all want to hear her sing some Afrobeats? Yeah, let's encourage
her. First of all, that's a trap. That's a trap. I never said I could sing. But since she has requested.
Yes.
Okay. If I tell you, say I love you. Where y'all at? Y'all gotta back me up. My money, my body, not your own. Oh, baby. 30 billion for the account here. Now y'all know you know this song.
Liz, I'm gonna leave Lovey up here to be embarrassed by herself. Bye-bye.
You see how she just set me up for failure? Lord. But back to business. So thank you, Kofi, for those remarks and the inspiring story of AAI's work. To present our first award, Please welcome to the stage AAI trustee, founder of Lifeline Financial Group and philanthropist, Humble Lukanga, and Tanzanian-American filmmaker, producer, and screenwriter, Ekwa Msangi. How y'all doing?
Good evening, good evening. Everybody looks so incredible tonight. I feel so honored to be with you guys. We are honored to be here tonight to present the first award. And the first award presented for this category, the Ambassador for African Cinema Award. This award was established to honor Mahen Bonetti's life. Yeah, come on. To honor her lifelong commitment to providing a platform for African voices and stories across the entire diaspora. Born in Sierra Leone, Mahen Bonetti has devoted her life's work to creating opportunities for Black storytellers to tell their stories through film, a medium which she believes offers unrivaled opportunities for healing and connection. She's the founder and executive director of African Film Festival, a film and cultural arts organization that presents year-round programming, including the internationally renowned New York African Film Festival. We have long admired and followed Bonetti's career, and we are so delighted to honor her tonight, to showcase her work and her commitment to African storytellers and African film. This award is long overdue.
So, where would African cinema be without Mahen Bonetti? A very lofty thing to say about someone so petite and unassuming, but trust me, Mahen is a force. I met Mahen when an attempt to design a master's program in African cinema for myself crumbled, and my advisor told me to call her. I introduced myself, explaining that I'd just recently discovered African cinema, despite having grown up on the continent, pre-Nollywood and digital distribution. And she simply said, okay, baby, come tomorrow. What I found in her archives were hundreds of films from all over the continent and diaspora. Some were works in progress, and some award-winning gems that had only been shown at the New York African Film Festival. Mahen had envisioned a forum in which Black filmmakers worldwide, including women and LGBTQ+, could share their stories and have dialogue with audiences and each other, and in some of the most respected cultural venues in New York City. Mahen has given us dignity, fighting tirelessly to ensure that our stories are regarded with the same reverence as any other genre of cinema. All the African cinema greats have come through her doors due to her persistence, be it petitioning for visas to travel filmmakers, or international phone calls to the village shopkeeper to send a child to find the filmmaker whose work she's determined to present. She made sure that everybody got their flowers, and for that, we, the African film community, are forever grateful and indebted to her. It is my honor to be here to celebrate this titan of a woman and to witness her turn to receive her flowers. And now, a short video illustrating the immense impact that Mahen has had throughout her career.
Dear Mahen, I am encouraged and joyful that the AAI has recognized you, the elegant, smiling, kind, generous, and accessible. In fact, all-round indomitable and fabulous person that you are, and your immense contribution to African cinema this year. Congratulations, dear.
Cette musique que vous venez d'écouter est pour toi, Mahen, c'est pour toi. L'universalisme donc que tu as choisi comme façon de vivre est quelque chose de magnifique et cette distinction est tout à fait méritée.
Elle a soutenu un grand soutien pour les réalisateurs et les réalisatrices. Elle a essayé de faire connaître notre travail, de nous faire rencontrer des gens et provoquer des collaborations. Je ne peux pas dire le nombre de gens à qui elle m'a présenté, avec qui elle m'a mis en connexion. Dès que je lui ai demandé, c'est quelqu'un d'extrêmement disponible, d'un grand soutien. Et moi, je le suis extrêmement reconnaissant. Et je la remercie quoi beaucoup.
It is so fitting that you should be honored with the Ambassador for African Cinema Award. Your relentlessness, your tenacity, your passion for giving African cinema the platform it deserves has never gone unnoticed. Thank you for existing. Thank you for fighting on our behalf. Thank you for reminding us of the power of our stories, our traditions, our culture. I love you and I celebrate you.
Mayan is a force to reckon with. I've known her for so many years. And I've seen how she started the African Film Festival, small but determined to make a dent, to make a place for the film of other countries that don't make it to the mainstream. Culture and movie from people that we will not, never heard about if it was not for her. I really salute her courage, her inspiration, and her determination in what everything that she does. Mayan, congratulations.
Please welcome to the stage our Ambassador for African Cinema honoree, Mayan Bonetsi.
Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. Yes, it is. Oh, here we go. Here it is. Here, there. I think I should turn it around. Yeah, there. There it is. Thank you so much. Greetings all around, and welcome to this momentous occasion. I'm profoundly grateful and deeply humbled by this prestigious recognition. I thank the founders of this eminent institution, the AAI team, and all whose selfless commitment over the years reaffirmed the enduring principles, values, and spirits that sparkle in this golden moment. Coming from Sierra Leone, a country with intricate ties to the Black diaspora, so many thoughts, warm memories, and common goals and resilient visions give us all at AAFF, I was going to say AAI, AFF, we're intricately tied, the will to forge on. Since 1990, as founding director of African Film Festival, Inc., we have advanced the traveling series across the United States, community programs that integrate the riches of African arts, cinematic expressions of the diaspora, lecture series, in-school programs, all of which actively engage audiences, transcending boundaries and fostering dialogues that remain pivotal to our mission. Notably, African creatives are passionate advocates for voices, visions, innovations, agency, art and activism. This ambassadorial position is not about diplomacy, nor is it a cliche. Based on indisputable trust, it is a call to service, a pledge to nurture the common thread of Africa that binds us with her diasporas and consolidates our extraordinary aspirations. I pledge with enthusiastic confidence, some might say fanatical, that the honor bestowed on me today will never fade. May this milestone engender fruitful alliances, robust visions for humanity, and serve as an authentic reference point for prosperity. I truly thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I am deeply humbled. Seriously, this came from nowhere, so thank you so, so much. Thank you.
No, it is fantastic. Can we give one more hand of applause, please? Yes. And another one for the outfits. Because look. Wait, was that one for my outfit or for their outfit? I'm not quite sure what was going on. But it's fine, it's fine. All the outfits. Thank you very much. To present our next award, we would like to welcome to the stage the AAI Institute Trustee and Chief Communications Officer at the ACLU, Rebecca Edwards, and Professor Philip Clay, former Chancellor of MIT. Please welcome them. Good evening. It is my honor to be here to present this next award, the Science and Technology Leadership Award. This award is given to individuals committed to advancing purpose-driven global innovation to enable a sustainable future. Dr. Solomon Assefa is a vice president at IBM Research, leading the global effort at IBM Research focused on developing core technologies for climate change mitigation and adaptation, healthcare and life sciences, commuting and nanotechnology. Under Dr. Assefa's leadership, hundreds of researchers from IBM's global labs are pioneering disruptive and commercially viable technologies such as sustainable hybrid cloud, AI-enabled material discovery for carbon capture, carbon footprint optimization and reduction, AI-driven climate risk and impact modeling, and user-centric decision support systems. And if that doesn't keep him busy enough, Dr. Assefa is also responsible for IBM's Africa Labs, located in Kenya and South Africa, fostering local innovation ecosystems by forming new models for partnerships with government, industry, academia, nonprofits, and startups. Under his leadership, the labs have developed scalable technology solutions for emerging markets and have been instrumental in the development of climate and sustainability technology, contributing towards solving Africa's grand challenges and serving as a global model.
It is an honor and a privilege to present this award to Dr. Solomon Assefa. Solomon was a PhD student at MIT. He was my favorite type of student. He was also my favorite student at one point. He was clearly smart, but more than that, he understood the link between knowledge and action, innovation and social progress, and between theory and practice. He had gravitas at an early age. In my work in African higher education, I've come to appreciate the necessity for having many more young Africans with the kind of drive, direction, and talent that Solomon possesses. His work is a model for connecting the so-called developing world to the West. He is a proud African who has worked with Africans to do the heavy lift of moving the continent in a way that provides sustainability that is both social, physical, and economic. Now, I also want to point out some highlights from his work, some of which have already been pointed out, They include his pioneering innovation on spin torque magnetic random access memory technologies. You know what that is. In addition, he has co-authored more than 150 papers. He has over 70 patents and has appeared as a guest speaker on a number of high-profile and impactful conferences, including Davos. We are honored to add to this list the well-deserved award from AAI for the 2022 Science and Technology Leadership Award, recognizing Solomon's dedication to advancing purpose-driven global innovation to enable a sustainable future for all.
I'm delighted to congratulate Solomon on his award from the Africa America Institute. Solomon, your work continues to show what's possible when we harness the world's best technical expertise with the energy, youth, and spirit of innovation in Africa. Congratulations again, Solomon, and my thanks to AAI for all you do to strengthen the bonds between Africa and America.
Congratulations, Solomon, for being honored with AAI's Science and Technology Leadership Award. It's richly deserved. I can't wait to see what you do next.
Solomon, a big congratulations for this incredibly well-deserved recognition. He's exactly the kind of partner that we crave and benefit from most at MIT.
Dr. Solomon, I would like to congratulate you on the award and would like to thank you for your mentorship and all that you have done for the continent and what you continue to do.
Solomon has left an indelible mark on the global technology, research, and climate and sustainability communities. Solomon, all of us at IBM could not be prouder of your achievements. And we're excited to see what you will continue to achieve on the road ahead. Congratulations.
Solomon loves this continent. He has invested a lot of time and effort in trying to ensure that he leaves a lasting legacy. Well done, Solomon. I'm proud of you, my brother.
Solomon, my dear, dear friend, I'm a little bit envious because I see how this childhood dream to learn, to be trained, to have an impact on the real world, and after that, return back with all your knowledge and everything back home to push the innovations on the continent is now fulfilled. You are, by definition, is playing a role of kind of a world citizen and bringing this knowledge, this angle into R&D in Africa is extremely important. So Solomon, my dear friend, my congratulations. I'm so happy for you. I'm so proud to be your friend and you're very close to my heart. So congratulations once again.
Please help me welcome to the stage with your loudest applause yet tonight, our 2022 Science and Technology Leadership Honoree, Dr. Solomon Asefa.
Okay, that was a little bit overwhelming. First time I'm seeing the video. So, good evening, everyone. And it's really my pleasure to be here with you tonight to celebrate the theme of Africa in the world. I would first like to congratulate the other honorees that are here with us tonight. I would also like to thank AAI for the commendable work in promoting Africa's growth and the continued work that AI is doing to develop the next generation of African leaders. Moreover, I would like to thank my colleagues at IBM. Some of them are here with us tonight. You know, they have worked with me to achieve breakthroughs in nanotechnology, quantum computing, AI and cloud, and even more importantly, in applying these technologies to some of the pressing global challenges that are facing business and society today. But most importantly, I want to thank my wife, she's here with us today, and without her love, support, and inspiration, none of my accomplishments would be possible. So, just to tell you a little bit about myself, I left Ethiopia when I just turned 17, my first plane ride out of my home country to come to the US and pursue my passion for science at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT. And of course, coming to the US at such an early age presented me with many challenges that turned into invaluable lessons in my life. One of these lessons was about setting inspirational goals and breaking barriers. Even when skeptics say that an African has never done it and an African would never do it. When I joined the iconic IBM Research Lab in Yorktown Heights, New York, my goal was to help drive scientific breakthroughs, invent new technologies, and also become a very influential technical executive. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, I am grateful to stand here in front of you and confirm that I did achieve those goals. But more importantly, I believe that I have opened doors to others around the world who wanted to be leaders in science and technology. That said, perhaps the biggest challenge I envisioned for myself was to return to Africa, to not only catalyze Africa's growth through science and technology, but also lead from Africa a worldwide team of researchers that are united in creating breakthroughs that are important in tackling global challenges such as climate change, mitigation, and adaptation. So why is it symbolic that I lead from Africa? Well, as much as Africa is known for a lot of people as the cradle of humankind, I also firmly believe that the destiny of humanity is intricately woven with the future of Africa. I believe that Africa's growth or decline will have the most consequential impact on our planet. We are making quite a bit of progress in our endeavors, but there's still a lot of work to be done. We need to continue to invest in science and technology, and we need to make science and technology readily available and accessible to everyone equally. From the young scientists in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, to the team of US scientists at the Oak Ridge National Lab in Tennessee. In closing, I would like to dedicate this award to my mother, who unfortunately passed away earlier this year. So despite lacking formal schooling and having raised 7 children, she was one of the brightest people that I have ever met. But more importantly, she taught me about unconditional love, hard work, humility and integrity, optimism, and the power of shared vision. So thank you very much.
My knees weren't going to manage that. Okay. All right. Well, congratulations, Solomon. Very, very proud of you. Very happy for you. Is everyone still enjoying? Yes? Okay. Because if you're enjoying, it is time to show your support of AAI by texting to donate. It got very quiet. Now, look, we're going to say something here. Because this is Africa America Institute, mm-hmm. we would like it to be known that we are not just accepting dollars. We are accepting CDs, because Ghana. We are not accepting Naira.
Hey! But wait. Not you choosing violence. Not you choosing violence, though.
But am I wrong?
The way
but
it just pains me. You see, I didn't even start today on Ghana Jollof. I didn't.
Wow.
I did not. But she wants to start on Naira. It's okay. Choosing violence.
Okay.
We're supposed to be picking peace.
This is peace. We're being peaceful. Okay. Because we are going to come together to donate. Correct, everyone? Yes. Okay. AI strives to enrich the social fabric of humanity by connecting students and leaders across sectors, facilitating access to reliable information about Africa, and transforming the way we understand Africa and its worldwide diaspora. Yep. So for the past 6 decades, AI has provided over 23,000 scholarships and fellowships to African students. 23,000. Yes. The annual awards gala raises funds to support AAI programs and initiatives, such as its work to assist K-12 districts and schools in the United States that want to expose students to scholarly, unbiased knowledge about Africa and advanced education and training scholarship programs for professionals across the African continent.
Yes, so your support is critical to AAI continuing this mission. So right now, pull out your phones, please.
Right now.
Everyone's looking all shifty now. I'm saying pull out phones. Okay. We want you to encourage to go to text GIVE, G-I-V-E. So pull out your phones and text 41444 is the number that you're texting. 41444 with the text, gala text, with the amount that you would like to give and your name. So let's do that again. You will text the number 41444 with the text gala text, or is it gala text? G-A-L-A text.
Yeah, that's why I told you
I'm
weren't
Nigerian.
Accepting Naira.
I have my accent, don't
this
worry.
This is what I told you. This is what okay. I told you.
With the amount that you would like to give and your name, and after you text, the donation is not complete until you click the link in the reply. So you gotta make sure you click the link. We are now gonna take a dinner break and come back for our last 2 awards, but first, please, we're expecting text messages.
And even from mobile money, correct?
Correct. We will accept Venmo, Zelle, Western Union is available. Let's just let us know. We're ready. Enjoy dinner.
All right.
With the sound of music, with songs they have sung for 1,000 years. The hills fill my heart with the sound of music. My heart wants to sing every song it hears. My heart wants to beat like the wings of the birds that rise from the lake to the trees. My heart wants to shine like a chime that flies from a church on a breeze. To laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones on its way. To sing through the night like a lark who is learning to pray. Oh, God, to the hills when my heart is lonely. I know I will hear what I've heard before. Thank you.
Thank you all so much. God bless you. God bless Africa. Have a great night, everybody. Thank you, AAI.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage, Lovey.
All right.
So,
is this a challenge? Because I could do it. Please give it up to Abiodun Koya. That was amazing. Such a beautiful performance. Fun fact, Sound of Music is one of my favorite films, and I have watched it probably 30 times. So that was definitely living my life. And another fun fact, God knew what they were doing when they did not allow me to know how to sing. Because if I could sing like that, I wouldn't even be speaking. I'd just be singing everything. You know, certain gifts were given to certain people for a reason. To present the Distinguished Alumna Award, please welcome to the stage Distinguished Professor, AAI Trustee and Alumni, Usaina Alidu, and former AAI Trustee and Vice President for Africa at the Rockefeller Foundation, William Asiko.
Habarigani. Everybody. Habari Jamal. Salam Shalom. Bonjour. Hello. Thank you, Lovey. We are honored to be here to present the Distinguished Alumna Awards. Each year, AAI present the Distinguished Alumna Award to an alumna or alumnus of one of AAI's education and training programs who has made a significant contributions to their country or field of work. Since our founding in 1953, over 23,000 Africans have received scholarships and fellowship from AAI, including myself. These Africans, including myself, are now an esteemed network of alumni, many of whom are leaders and influencers across public, private, governmental sectors in Africa and globally. As a visionary organization, the African American Institute has ensured the training of young African women to STEM fields, as exemplified today by AAI's Distinguished Alumni Awardee. With multiple challenges in global ecology and climate vulnerability and change, gender equity has become more critical than ever. In 2003, Ms. Kabera received a scholarship from the Africa America Institute under our Strategic Technical Assistance for Results with Training Program to pursue a Master of Science in Agricultural and Resource Economics at Colorado State University. From there, she worked as a research fellow at the Tegemeo Institute of Agricultural Policy and Development at Egerton University to her current role as Director of Food Initiative at the Rockefeller Foundation's Africa Regional Office based in Nairobi, Kenya. As an alumna myself, It is truly my honor to present this year's Distinguished Alumna Award to Betty. We could not be more proud of her life and career. Hongera.
At the Rockefeller Foundation, Betty serves as the regional champion for the foundation's initiative in strengthening food security, agribusiness, and resilience to the devastating effects of climate change, including investments in regenerative agriculture to enable real, sustainable, and equitable economic growth. Betty also leads the foundation's investments in the implementation of the Good Food Strategy, whose goal is to improve dietary quality through an equitable and regenerative food system. Betty is a highly innovative individual. She has pioneered and developed the smart food markets of the future. She has led the YieldWise initiative to reduce food loss and the foundation's investments in innovation and insect-based feed as an alternative protein. This year, Betty is serving as the co-lead of the 17 Rooms Working Group on the UN Sustainable Development Goal number 2 for Zero Hunger, focusing on advancing targeted actions to create a continental strategy for insect-based food, feed, and fertilizers for the African Union to adopt and promote across the continent. These are just some of the pioneering accomplishments under Betty's belt. For me personally, as the Vice President for the Africa Regional Office of the Rockefeller Foundation, it has been a pleasure to work with Betty, and I'm overjoyed that the African American Institute, of whom I am a former director, has recognized her this year. As we celebrate Betty, let us look at some of the additional work and words of tribute for her that have been put together in this video.
Betty's leadership in providing innovative investments in the smart food markets of the future is a testament of her outstanding role and contribution to development in Africa. As the Swahili proverb says, Nyota njema huonekana asubuhi, which means a good star is seen in the morning. Betty Kibara's star and destiny has always been visible, a shining light, and charting a path and contributing to development in Africa by transforming food systems through innovative investments. On behalf of the Eastern Africa Grain Council, I say a hearty congratulations.
Betty, my heartfelt gratitude goes to you for a well-deserved and outstanding achievement. The beneficiary of your influence, I've seen you champion a multitude of projects in strengthening food security in the African continent and beyond. And we've seen millions of US dollars being attracted from other donors into this sector, forward ever, backward never. I am so proud of you, Betty.
Some of you may not know, but Betty comes from a very humble background. She has a passion for helping others, and she does this not just in her work, but in her spare time as well. Betty, I think it's so wonderful that you've dedicated your life to helping others and helping others develop their potential and uplift themselves, and that's the best legacy that we can leave behind. So Betty, congratulations on this wonderful award. You are in great company. Well done.
Please welcome to the stage the AAI 2022 Distinguished Alumna Honoree, Betty Wambui Kibira.
Thank you so much. What a moment. I'm humbled to receive this award, and I'm grateful for the recognition of my work, and congratulations to my fellow recipients. This award came as a surprise to me, as a little girl, the little girl in me that grew up in a small village in eastern Kenya could not have dreamt of a moment like this. My interest in agriculture was ignited when my mother lost her job in a tea factory, forcing our family to move to the village. For a moment, just picture this, a city kid on a village farm. I learned how to cook with firewood, to fetch water from a stream, and to till the land. It was challenging, I must say, and many times the crop failed, and when we had a harvest, there was no market. And I knew that whatever I did, I wanted to make a difference for the farmers. Auntie Rispa, my auntie, later took me in to live with her in the city. And she became my mentor, and she taught me the value of education. And I completed my university degree in agribusiness management in Kenya. Thereafter, the African America Institute, sponsored my master's degree at Colorado State University. I want to thank AAI for providing me with these resources to make a difference in the world. I had an opportunity, thank you. I had an opportunity to follow my dreams because of my partner in life, my husband. Just remain standing. Yes. So he took care of our 1.5 year young daughter. When I came to the US, he's my pillar, and Sammy, I thank you so much. Okay, to my daughter who was left at 1.5 years. She is here in the house, Melody. My one word to you, follow your dreams wherever they will. They might take you. You can take a seat. And then a huge gratitude to my American host family, Greg and Sherry Smith, who are here with me today. Thank you. Please stand up and just wave. As a lonely African student, you can imagine how it feels when you've left your 1.5 year old daughter. And they were able to take care of me, and we have remained friends since then. Now, my career trajectory then led me to the Rockefeller Foundation, where I have served for 13 years. And I want to thank all my colleagues who are with me here today, and in particular, Dr. Roy Steiner. Roy, just wave at me. And then William Masiko, who are here today, and many others. Where is table 35? Thank you so much. So it is not always easy to see how a small scholarship and a small grant can impact someone's life. But I am a proof that it can change in monumental ways. And looking back, what made the difference for me? It is the word opportunity. Opportunity that my parents gave me to go to school. The opportunity that AAI gave me to sharpen my skills here in the US, and the opportunity the Rockefeller Foundation has given me to pursue my dream in supporting African farmers, and the opportunity to also be mentored, and above all, God's unmerited favor. So, to any child who is wondering, where will life this life take me? Child, your birth is not your destiny. Work hard, stay focused, and pray. And to each one of you who are here present today, you can change a life, you can make opportunities universal and sustainable. That true example of this is me, who is standing right here in front of you. Thank you so much.
And now, please welcome back to the stage, Bozema.
If I tell you, say I love you, oh. My money, my body, now your own, oh baby. 30 billion for the account, yo. Versace and Gucci for your body, oh baby.
All right, all right, all right. Thank you so much. All right, and congratulations, Betty. It is quite remarkable, I think, for an African woman who is in Colorado. I grew up in Colorado Springs, Colorado myself. So can we make some noise for some African girls in the middle of the United States of America? Yeah, that deserves its own award, but we can get into that some other time. All right, to present our final distinguished award for this evening, I would like to welcome Mamadou Baye, AAA Trustee and General Manager, Corporate Affairs for the Middle East, Africa, and South America at Chevron, and Professor Benedict Arama, the President and Chairman of Afriks Bank.
All right, good evening. I hope we've been here now listening, hearing, applauding individual awards. Brilliant mind, brilliant Africans who have really made a difference in their different fields. But in order to make that happen and to sustain that, we need also very strong countries on the continent so we can produce more brilliant mind that you heard today. So thank you very much for being here. In 1999, the AAI National Achievement Award was established to recognize the citizens of an African nation for their achievements and demonstrated commitment to effective and just governance. These honorees also were to have invested in the well-being of people through education, health, peace building, environmental protection, promoting sustainable economic freedom through policies that foster entrepreneurship. The country that I'm going to nominate today, you all know, there are not that many on the continent, so we need to have more of it. Botswana embodies Botswana embodies each of these qualities. It is a true beacon of light and progress on the continent and the world. Its commitment to democracy, tremendous strides in education, healthcare, global partnership, economic development are models for all nations. The way you have managed your natural resources is a counterexample of the curse of resources. I was just telling you, how has a Malian will be honored to learn from you how to manage our gold, the way you manage your diamond. Congratulations for it. These awards are important because they provide a vehicle for bringing the tremendous and often unknown accomplishments of awardees to the attention of the international community. We need to celebrate our successes, countries and individuals, and Botswana is an example. Thank you. Everyone associated with AAI is proud to pay tribute to the people of Botswana and to this distinguished leader, President Masisi. Thank you for being here tonight. Mr. President, as a son of the continent, I speak for those of us from Africa, from the diaspora, and for all of those who have committed their careers to working on behalf of Africa. in saying that these are, in saying that we are all honored by your presence and proud to bestow upon you the 2022 National Achievement Awards.
Thank you, Amadi. And thank you, Kofi. Botswana is a remarkable country. Since the 1960s, it has maintained a commendable growth rate at par or even better than most Asian economies we look up to as the fastest growing economies in the world. Botswana is perhaps one of the first countries in Africa to be rated and to achieve investment grade ratings. A true commitment to democracy and good governance that has been there since the 1960s. Botswana has remained one of the countries that people look up to when they want to consider how to run good economies. And the quality of leadership, the quality of people that we have in Botswana also have been instrumental in helping to shape how countries can better manage their natural resources. So under the leadership of His Excellency President Masisi, we have seen Botswana even do more. Moving from minerals-led to a knowledge-based economy. And the government has also implemented reforms to make its products and services more competitive in the global market. I remember a number of times I've had the privilege of being in meetings with President Masisi, when I hear what his visions are and how he presents them with passion. At the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, I also knew how he was personally involved in making sure that Botswana came out of it without a major crisis. And the reforms of His Excellency President Masisi underpin the strong recovery made by the country in 2021, with growth rate at 12.5%. That is after the economy had contracted by about 8.7% as a result of the COVID pandemic in 2020. That is a remarkable achievement. And His Excellency President Masisi has also paid attention to human beings, human development, the quality of life, showing an understanding that the greatest resource of any country is the human beings there and not the natural resources on the ground. And in this regard, with regard to healthcare, Botswana has shown strong commitment to tackling the HIV/AIDS disease that we all know have been devastating many countries in Africa. And it has achieved and exceeded the UNAIDS 95-95-95 ratio target. With 95% of the people being aware of their HIV status, 98% of those on treatment, and 98% virally suppressed. Botswana's long-standing commitment to public-private partnerships offers a prime example for the world on how to tackle some of our most pressing challenges. At Afreximbank, the institution that I lead, we've had a very good relationship with the government of Botswana over the years. And I must commend His Excellency President Masisi for continuing to give us the opportunity to serve the people, to provide the financing that is required for trade and for development. And we will continue to work with you to make sure that as you develop your people, develop your economy, we also help you to pursue the diversification you have made your priority. It is my distinct honor to have been given the opportunity to present the final award of tonight, the National Achievement Award to the people of the Republic of Botswana. And accepting the award today on behalf of the people of Botswana, His Excellency President Masisi himself. But before we ask His Excellency to come to the podium, please take a moment to look at the video of tributes from Botswana's many partners and friends from all over the world.
It's an honor to congratulate His Excellency President Masisi for this outstanding recognition of his leadership. Texas Children's Hospital has had a long-standing relationship with Botswana, first successfully addressing the pediatric AIDS epidemic, and more recently, working to meet the challenge of childhood cancer. I'm grateful for the leadership and partnership of His Excellency and the First Lady, who are helping to save the lives of many thousands of children.
Good evening. I am delighted to congratulate the people of the Republic of Botswana on receiving the National Achievement Award. Your Excellency, I fully expect to see Botswana build on its already outstanding reputation under your excellent leadership.
Your Excellency, we wish to congratulate you on this well-deserved honor. Breho Lebohisa, congratulations.
I want to offer sincere congratulations to the people of the Republic of Botswana and to His Excellency, President Masisi. Botswana stands as a true beacon of democracy for not only Africa, but the rest of the world as well.
We deeply believe Botswana will lead the way in cancer care in Africa. Your Excellency, thank you for prioritizing health, education, and economic development.
On behalf of the Baylor College of Medicine, we salute you and the people of Botswana for this well-deserved acknowledgement of your unique success. And of course, Your Excellency, we always welcome you back to your second home in Texas.
I'm delighted this evening to share my thanks, my congratulations to Tatona Masisi in the receipt of this award. And I look forward to continuing my close relationship with Botswana, which has truly been one of the joys of my life. Ritumeetse.
On behalf of Texas Children's Hospital, we are proud to be a long-standing partner of the Republic of Botswana and honored to acknowledge the African America Institute's 2022 National Achievement Award to the people of Botswana.
Botswana's response to COVID-19 was decisive and swift, and we are proud to have had a part through health information technology that enabled us to host over 40 webinars to share crucial information. Thank you for your leadership.
President Masisi has a strong commitment to this part of the world and to his people. We see him as a partner since he's been vice president, and now as president, we see him as a leader for the continent. We couldn't have any more respect for him. We're happy that he's being honored tonight. We look forward to working with him and to serving his greater cause and that of the people of Botswana.
Your Excellency, President Masisi, the work we have done together in your country continues to be so important. Botswana stepped forward and quickly exemplified how public-private partnerships were key to successfully addressing some of the world's most challenging health crises. Thank you for your continued leadership, commitment, your partnership, and your passion.
So, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to stand. And I will ask you, as the president will be walking, start applauding an example, true example of Africa.
Thank you very much. I've got some side commentators here. Well, well, well. What does one say? Well, the director of ceremonies and Your Excellency, the President of African Student Bank, my good friend from Mali, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, my dear wife and First Lady of the Republic, Neo Jane Masisi, Your Excellency, the Prime Minister, and my good friend from Bahamas, and your dear wife, my neighbor at the table and chair of the board of AAI, and the president and chief executive of AAI, Mr. Apin Teng. Former ambassador of the United States of America to Botswana, and your dear spouse. What's your table number? 8-7. Honorable ministers from the Republic of Botswana and senior government officials, ambassador of the Republic of Botswana to the US, Temukaila, and ambassador and permanent representative to the UN for Botswana, Rekela Pile, Mr. John Jamonti, President of Bristol Myers Squibb, the two former ministers of health of the Republic of Botswana. I'm trying to see where they're sitting. Joy Pumape and Professor Sheila Dlou. Distinguished awardees, excellencies, distinguished guests, dear friends, a very good evening. I'd like to begin by giving due acknowledgement and asking them to rise for you to see. And please, this is the last award, so give me time. I want to introduce them one by one. The people that really made it happen. Because in Botswana, we are a wonderful team. A brilliant team that spans the generations. I'll start with the most senior, who was the first Minister of Health among those who are here, and former Deputy Executive Director of WHO, Joy Pumape, now working for ALMA. Joy, where are you? Yeah, there's Joy. She was the Minister of Health at the helm at the height of the HIV/AIDS crisis with President Mukhai. Thank you, Joy. She was followed by Professor Sheila Dlou. If any of you have not found the Fountain of Youth, talk to Sheila. She is also Minister of Health in Botswana at the height of the HIV/AIDS pandemic, and she continues to do marvelous work in that field. And then a former Minister of Health and currently the Minister of Foreign Affairs for the Republic of Botswana, Dr. Lemogang Kwape. Thank you. And the current Minister of Health and former Minister of Agriculture, Dr. Dikoloti. And the current Minister of Education and Skills Development, Dr. Lesula Tebe. Sorry, Dr. Lesula Tebe, can you remain standing, please? Dr. Dikoloti, can you stand, please? These are my two bachelor ministers. So, if anybody wants to see me, and the Minister of Minerals and Energy, Mr. Lefoko Moahi, and you all talk of women empowerment, we do it. We do it. Because I was very happy and proud to appoint the first head of the public service in the Republic of Botswana as a woman, Emma Pilwitlitsi. That is she. And next to her is the ebullient Permanent Secretary for Foreign Affairs, Dr. Mukawa. And next to Dr. Wape is Ma Muzila. She's a PS for Ministry of Health. And Ma Madisa is a Permanent Secretary for Ministry of Minerals. This is Madisa. Permanent Secretary means the head of the ministry. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 very powerful women. And then there's my senior private secretary to the president, who is an equivalent of permanent secretary, Masetabi. There she is. And there's my chief of protocol, Machingapani. And there's a permanent secretary for the press, broadcasting media, Mr. Dipuwe. And then I think I come to the ambassadors and former minister of minerals, former minister of environment, former minister of transport, former member of parliament, and my former senior at primary school and secondary school, Kizo Mugaila. He's ambassador of Botswana to the United States based in Washington. And then there's Botswana's ambassador to the UN and permanent representative, Mr. Gelapile. And then, can I ask the other table, Botswana team, to please rise? I don't know who I'm forgetting over there. Hey, thank you. There's one other permanent secretary sitting over there, permanent secretary for Ministry of Education and Skills Development, Maroba. All right? These are the people who make it happen in Botswana and a lot of those who came before them. It's indeed a great honor for me to participate in the Africa American Institute 38th Annual Awards Gala to celebrate the successes made on the African continent. I thank profusely the African American Institute, in particular, Mr. Kofi Appentain. A man of immense qualities, I learned quite rapidly. The AAI's president and the chief executive officer, I thank you for your leadership and for the excellent example you have set to recognize and to highlight the achievements of the citizens of Africa annually during the United Nations General Assembly Week. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm deeply humbled by the honor you have bestowed on my fellow citizens, the people of the Republic of Botswana, with the AAI's 2022 National Achievement Award. Since taking office in April 20, actually in on April 1, it wasn't April Fool, but it was for real. On the 1st of April 2018, I've committed to work with all my heart to put the Botswana, the people of Botswana, at the epicenter of my government's development agenda. Despite the unprecedented global challenges of COVID-19, the people of Botswana have continued to place trust and confidence in me and my government. I wish to preface my remarks by underscoring Botswana's unwavering commitment to good governance, to democracy, and the rule of law through the Kotla system, which predates our independence, and yes, it predates our era of protectorate status. Peace and unity have been the bedrock of our democratic dispensation, and this is manifested in our personal names that we give to our children, such as Kagiso, meaning peace, Boitumelo, happiness, and many others, including the idiomatic expressions we use as part of our linguistic expressions. Meaning every person, irrespective of age, size, creed, and I guess in those times, orientation too, is free and at liberty to express their views. This is deeply ingrained in our DNA. And if you want to dissect a Botswana, a citizen of Botswana, you will find these attributes. In July of 2022, the government of Botswana partnered with the National Democratic Institute to co-host the Summit on Constitutionalism and Democratic Consolidation in Africa. As part of the Global Community for Democracy, I was very pleased to bolster efforts to promote dialogue on constitutionalism, presidential term limits, and peaceful transition of power in Africa and abroad. Just for the record, I shall underscore that. As part of the global community for democracy, I was very pleased to bolster efforts to promote dialogue on constitutionalism, presidential term limits, and peaceful transition of power in Africa and abroad. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, at the outbreak of the pandemic, and in heeding the World Health Organization's advisory for containing its spread, the government of Botswana pledged to save Botswana's population and livelihoods. This was made possible through the implementation of life-saving programs and a successful vaccination strategy. As a result, Botswana has vaccinated more than 71% of our population, which is one of the highest vaccination rates in the world. To further fortify our preparedness and the protective measures for saving Botswana lives from dreadful diseases like COVID-19, both in the present and in the future, Botswana continue to explore partnerships to improve our health systems and to manufacture COVID-19 vaccines. Strategic partnerships from the United States of America have been gracious, strategic partners from the USA have been gracious to heed this call, such as Texas Children's Hospital that Professor Poplack and Mike Wallace referred to, and Baylor College of Medicine that Professor Klotman referred to, and many others. I thank you for your unwavering support. As I reflect on the achievements we made, I also remember the many lives lost to COVID-19. Therefore, allow me to take this opportunity to extend my heartfelt condolences to all the families who have lost loved ones during this pandemic, and may their souls rest in eternal peace. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is reassuring to receive this token of appreciation under the current global conditions of crisis and uncertainty. It shows that good ways always triumph over despair. Thank you for this affirmation. On behalf of the government of the people of Botswana, on behalf of the government and the people of the Republic of Botswana, I'm deeply honored to receive the AAI's 2022 National Achievement Award. This award follows years of channeling a considerable amount of our limited resources to education, to health, to water, to youth programs, and infrastructural development, amongst others. Yes, we're known for diamonds and diamond production, but every diamond in my country means a vaccine. It means a road. It means a clinic. No wonder you don't see many Botswana men or women blinging too much. And if they do seem to bling, it's probably high-quality glass. As one of the poorest countries in the world at independence, it is particularly incumbent upon us to invest and to build strong partnerships with our development partners and our allies to alleviate poverty and build a stable and competitive economy. Dear friends, literally 21 years ago to this day, Dr. Festus Khontibane Mokgae, the former president of the Republic of Botswana, in an address to the United Nations General Assembly, appealed passionately to the international community to help Botswana because the country was literally, as he said, threatened with extinction, as it had no medical school, had a shortage of doctors, and an HIV prevalence of over 40%. Following this clarion call, Bristol-Myers Squibb Foundation, in partnership with the Baylor College of Medicine and the Texas Children's Hospital, as well as the government of Botswana, built the first pediatric HIV/AIDS care and treatment center of excellence on the African continent. On December 1st, 2021, the World Health Organization, as has been stated, announced that Botswana was the first high-burden country in the world to achieve a silver tie status for being on the path to elimination of mother-to-child transmission of HIV, a first in Africa. Another milestone for the people of Botswana occurred in July this year at the World AIDS Conference next door in Montreal, where it is announced by UNAIDS that Botswana is on track to reach the 95, which is 95% of individuals knowing their status, 95% being on treatment, and 95% having viral suppression targets ahead of the 2030 global goals. And may just be the very first country in Africa to eliminate HIV infections. Wow. Years of serious investment. Currently, as a matter of fact, our score is at 95.1%, 98%, and 97.9%. In 2022, and the engines are still revving. I'm grateful to note that the government and the people of Botswana responded to the COVID-19 pandemic with the same zeal as they did with the HIV pandemic, leading Africa in its response. Furthermore, the government of Botswana is currently facilitating the construction of a vaccine manufacturing facility to produce and distribute Pulavax regionally. NANT Botswana, Baylor College of Medicine, and Texas Children's Hospital have formed a strategic partnership to execute this important project. But it will not be limited to COVID vaccines only, it will be broadening. We'll start with the compounding and we'll produce other, particularly those vaccines for those ailments that are ignored. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the erstwhile political leadership and its crop of highly competent technocrats has also committed over the years to work within the framework of the multilateral system of the United Nations, whose organs provided various kinds of assistance in capacitating the Botswana government to execute the national development agenda. In this regard, I wish to thank all my predecessors for their crucial and meaningful contributions for Botswana's development. I am, as you might have heard, the fifth president to lead the country since 2018. So my four predecessors, all having enjoyed successful tenures and peaceful transitions, played their part. The sixth president will come at the right time. We go for elections in 2024. If I lose, I go home and the sixth gets inaugurated. If I win, I'll go on until 2028 and 31st of March at the stroke of midnight, I automatically lose all power. And whoever is the vice president, Dr. Letsola Thebe, automatically assumes power. Today, ladies and gentlemen, Botswana is an upper middle income country. My government aims to position Botswana to become, yes, a high income country by 2036. Our national vision espouses that we build and transform our existing institutions and we rethink the way we do business. I can assure you, we have started and we're in a hurry. To further facilitate this transition, the government of Botswana has introduced the Reset Agenda, which seeks to improve value chain development to unlock opportunities in key sectors of minerals, tourism, agriculture, health, and education, among others. The Reset Agenda, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, came about as our strategic response to the onslaught of COVID-19 and the devastation it brought about to our economy. And so the 12.7% we talked about was in part a response to that through our reforms. We're also determined to take advantage of cutting-edge technologies offered by the fourth industrial revolution. The government of Botswana has developed a digitalization and innovation strategy that aims for a knowledge-based, smart, and sustainable society without leaving anyone behind. We call the strategy, for short, Smart Bots, Digital Society Reinvented. This will unlock and enable high productivity among our people. I note with pleasure that the National Achievement Award comes at an opportune moment when the government of Botswana has undertaken a commitment to drive the transformation of Botswana's economy through job creation and facilitating a transition from a resource-based economy to a knowledge-based one. We also intend to identify new sectors in the global export product space that we can successfully grow in Botswana, resulting in significant job creation for our youth, while also driving the much-needed export diversification. Therefore, to unlock opportunities through inspiration, innovation, and exploration, Botswana successfully hosted the first Forbes Under 30 Africa Summit in April 2022. And if any of you are under 30, see you next year in April in Botswana. In conclusion, I wish to take this opportunity to congratulate my fellow honorees and to acknowledge their contributions to the development and well-being of the African continent and those in the diaspora. I urge all of us here tonight to keep working towards promoting peace and development, national unity and global solidarity. I also wish to express my profound gratitude to the African American Institute for this great honor. I thank you enormously for your attention tonight. And as we say in my country and my language, Pula. Papa,
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage, Lovey.
Thank you. Yes. All right. How's everybody doing? Y'all all right? All right. Congratulations, Botswana. So, yeah, put your hands together one more time. We would now like to welcome our chair of the Board of Trustees, Ms. Crystal Jackson.
History will record that one of the greatest connectors of the African diaspora is Mr. Kofi Appintane. If you join me tonight and give Kofi a round of applause. Yeah. I want to thank my fellow Board of Trustee members. I want to thank Jordan and Yvonne, Lovey and Bose for your contribution in making tonight so wonderful. Given the challenge, yes, give them a round of applause, that's right. Given the challenges the world has faced over the past 2 years, we are so excited to once again gather in person to celebrate the genius of Africa and its worldwide diaspora. Our collective journey is a reflection of our commitment to excellence and legacy, which we want to leave for generations to come. Tonight, you have heard about our great work, the school services program, and our history of awarding scholarships and fellowships to Africans. These individuals comprise an esteemed network of alumni, many of whom are leaders and influencers across public, private, and governmental sectors in Africa and globally. Included in this network, now bear with me, I practice these names. Included in this network are current heads of state, His Excellency Age Nguba, President of the Republic of Namibia, His Excellency Alassane Ouattara, the President of Cote d'Ivoire, His Excellency Mohamed Bazoum, the President of the Republic of Niger, and tonight's honoree, Betty Kabara. On behalf, yes, I did it. Okay, you approved. On behalf of AAI and the entire board, I would like to again thank our sponsors, my fellow board member, Mamadou and Chevron, Derek and the NAACP, and the Bloomberg Foundation. All of tonight's partners and donors, thank you so much. Thank you. Again, I would like to make another request for each of you in this room to support the mission of AAI in your own way as we seek to enrich the social fabric of humanity by transforming the way we all understand Africa and its worldwide diaspora. It is your support that allows us to continue this vital work, and we are so honored to be on this journey with you. So right now, I would encourage you to take out your phones and text to give 41444 Gala text. Don't forget, after you make your donation, you have to click the link in the reply button once you see it. So to make sure you click the link. Thank you again for your support and partnership. And we look forward to celebrating with all of you next year. Mark your calendar. On Tuesday, September 26th, not certain if it'll be the same location, but that's the date, for our 70th anniversary gala. Mark your calendars now. Again, thank you very much.
And now, please welcome back our hosts, Bozema and Lovey.
I'm a
Oh man, well, we have had ourselves quite a wonderful evening, have we not?
Yes,
we have. What a delight. And I am especially honored to have been here tonight after receiving an award myself in 2017. Thank you very much. And for hosting in 2019. But I have to say, this year was pretty good. Thank you, Lovey.
My pleasure. Glad to be here with you
too. Wonderful, wonderful. And we would like to thank our sponsors for the evening. And also, certainly, congratulations to Kofi and the team at AAI. Thank you so much for an incredible event. Please give a round of applause to the whole team.
Yes, and we would like to again congratulate all of our honorees, Mahen Bonetti, Dr. Solomon, Asefa, Betty Kibara, and the people of the Republic of Botswana.
Yes, 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 yes.
We thank you all for coming this evening and ask that you continue to support the Africa American Institute. So have a wonderful evening and see you next year for the 70th anniversary gala.
And don't forget, there are more cocktails. So we'll see you at the post-celebration event.
Drink her up.
On over there. Good night, everyone.